Hi there, Doug Stimmel with IT Creations. And today I have the Gigabyte G493-ZB1 GPU Server. I will add that Gigabyte created Giga Computing in early 2023 for the enterprise portion of the business. And this G493-ZB1 is definitely the business. It features AMD EPYC 9004 or 9005 series processors in a 4U chassis full of butterflies and rainbows. Actually better, it's an NVIDIA certified system and can be outfitted with up to 10 dual slot Gen 5 GPUs. I realize this may be a commitment, but hit that subscribe button if you like our channel. I mean, it's right there, right there. What is this system good for? High performance workloads, AI, AI inference and training, visual computing, basically all the complex stuff. With both 9004 and 9005 series EPYC processors supported, you have options. I mean, for the 9004 series, there's Bergamo, Genoa, and Genoa X. Fortunately, with the 9005 series, you only have to deal with Turin. Genoa offers AMD's Zen 4 architecture and up to 96 high-performance cores, and then you have the three flavors of Genoa X with some serious levels of cache memory for technical workloads. Bergamo offers the highest core counts of up to 128 cores, but is also designed for power efficiency and cloud-native workloads with AMD's Zen 4C architecture. Turin with the 9005 series processors will provide up to 192 physical cores using Zen 5C architecture, or up to 128 cores with Zen 5 architecture. The front of the system features two low-profile PCIe Gen 5 by 16 slots in the upper portion, with a bank of 12 2.5-inch drive bays below that. Eight of those drive bays are compatible with Gen 5 NVMe, SATA, and SAS-4 drive formats, while the other four support only SATA or SAS-4 drive types. For SAS drive support and RAID, you will need to install an add-in card. A small I/O panel along the base of the chassis on the right-hand side includes an RJ45 management LAN port, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, and a series of buttons and telltale lights. Those include a reset button, non-maskable interrupt, HDD status, and system status LED, then an on-off button and unit ID button. Two more RJ45 1 Gigabit Ethernet LAN ports for basic network communications are beside those. Need to do a little Bitcoin mining? Or maybe designing the next AI? Or maybe an SI? You know, Silicon Intelligence. If that's the case, you will need the performance to match those lofty goals, and the Gigabyte G493-ZB1 GPU server may be just the ticket. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that's listed or one that you can configure using our handy online configurator tool. That's valued at $5,000 or more. Click that link for more information. I asked Google's Gemini AI if that was a good deal. They said, yes, that is generally considered a good deal. Around the back of the system, there is a column of four stacked 3000 watt titanium power supply units offering 3+1 redundancy. Then on top, a GPU fan module with two dual fan cages bolted to the outside of the chassis. Those fans are for two by 16 PCI slots with a horizontal connection. That GPU fan module may be lacking in design intent, but definitely effective for heat removal. I have noticed Gigabyte does not have a problem in general adding a fan module to the outside of the chassis, especially on those 2U 8 GPU servers. I don't have a problem with it either. As I said, effective. Management of the system is through the integrated ASPEED AST2600 Baseboard Management Controller, or BMC, which is accessible through that RJ45 Gigabit Ethernet LAN port on the front of the chassis. Gigabyte servers come pre-installed with the Gigabyte Management Console, which is for a single server or a small cluster of servers. It offers remote monitoring and management of the system through a graphic user interface and features event recording, power control, and firmware updates, plus monitoring and control of Broadcom MegaRAID adapters. Offering more robust management features and for managing large clusters of servers, Gigabyte offers Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM. GSM is free to download and allows for centralized monitoring and management of server clusters. There's a mobile app, command line interface, and a plugin for use with VMware vCenter for real-time monitoring and management of server clusters. Once inside the case, you can see that PCIe tray on the top with two PCIe 5.0 by 16 slots just behind the GPU fan module. Once we tilt that tray up, you can see eight more slots for double-wide high-performance GPUs. Behind those slots, a bank of 12 fans stacked 2x2 on 6 columns. For GPUs supported on the system, the qualified vendor list includes the NVIDIA A100 80GB L40 with 48GB, the RTX 6000 Ada with 45GB GDDR6, and the L4 with 24GB of VRAM. The first three have a 300-watt power draw and will need a 16-pin lifeline from the motherboard for more power. That last one, the L4, has a 75-watt power draw accessible from the PCI slot. Also listed is the AMD Instinct MI210 with 64 gigabytes of VRAM and also a 300-watt power draw. This system specifically states 10 PCI Gen 5 GPUs. In other words, GPUs that can use that PCI 5.0 interface. With that PCI 5.0x16 interface on each of the GPU slots, this system can be outfitted with later model GPUs. All of the Ada Lovelace line would be considered Gen 4. So for Gen 5, we're looking at Blackwell architecture. And there are several that could meet the relatively low bar I arbitrarily established at 300 watts TDP for the GPUs. Unofficially, this platform can take GPUs with a TDP of up to 400 watts each, assuming they fit. Specifically, the NVIDIA RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Max-Q Workstation Edition could work. That one has a power draw of up to 300 watts, well within the theoretical wattage, which was never stated for the system anyways. The RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell GPU without the Max-Q has a power draw of 600 watts, so I think that one is a no-go. However, let's not be too hasty on that one. NVIDIA does say this RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Server Edition is configurable in regards to power and cooling, so it can be deployed in different server environments. First off, it does have a passive cooling solution, contrasting with the Max-Q cooling solution, which is quite active. Secondly, and probably more important, the power draw can be adjusted between 400 watts and 600 watts. With that, I think we have a fifth generation GPU fit. Out of the cards listed, only the NVIDIA L40 is certified by NVIDIA for this platform. The other three are qualified. Qualified GPUs go through several rounds of rigorous testing, just not as much as a certified GPU. The GPU board is connected to the CPUs on the motherboard via two PLX switches. We have dual 9004 series AMD EPYC 9334 CPUs, codenamed Genoa, installed. They offer 32 physical cores and 64 virtual threads each, a base frequency of 2.7 GHz and a max boost of 3.9 GHz. These are from the Genoa line and have a modicum of L3 cache at 128 MB, also 12-channel memory architecture. The configurable thermal design power rating is at up to 400 watts for each CPU, but if the ambient temperature is consistent at 25 degrees Celsius, which is a slightly warm 77 degrees Fahrenheit, then you're good to go with CPUs at up to 500 watts TDP. In total, there are 48 memory module slots divided between the two processors for 24 slots each of DDR5 registered DIMMs. At full capacity, it can provide up to 12 terabytes of memory using 256 gigabyte memory modules in all slots. Memory speed is dependent on the installed processor, memory modules, and memory configuration. With 9005 series CPUs and one DIMM per channel, optimal memory speed of up to 5200 megatransfers per second is supported. 9004 series CPUs will bring that speed down to 4800 megatransfers per second at one DIMM per channel. With two DIMMs per channel, memory speeds are further reduced. Also on that motherboard are two PCI 3.0x4 slots for NVMe M.2 drives. Those drives can be used for additional storage or to boot the system and can be placed in a mirror RAID 1 for resiliency. However, I will direct you back to my initial comment on storage. For SAS drive support and RAID, you will need a controller. This platform was outfitted with the NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada GPU, which is a professional graphics card launched at the end of 2022. It features a PCI 4.0x16 interface and combines 3rd-gen RT cores, 4th-generation Tensor cores, and next-gen CUDA cores. Yes, it does have 4 DisplayPort 1.4 ports for attaching monitors, which are on by default, as this card is typically for workstations. However, they can be disabled for server applications using NVIDIA's virtual GPU technology. That vGPU technology will only work on certain NVIDIA GPUs, like the L4, L40, RTX A6000 Ada, and some variants. It allows the GPU resources to be virtualized and shared. The system can also be outfitted with one or two NVIDIA BlueField 2 DPU cards using those upfront PCI card slots. However, even though the slots in back are specifically for GPUs, you can indeed add more network cards or even HD controllers using those slots. The DPU on that BlueField 2 card stands for Data Processing Unit. It combines a high-speed network adapter, in this case the NVIDIA ConnectX-6 DX, with programmable ARM cores that bypass the CPU to deliver networking, storage, and security. With a BlueField 2 DPU installed, the CPU can focus on core application processing, while the DPU enables faster data processing and analytics. It optimizes your data traffic for greater performance and efficiency across a range of applications. telecommunications and 5G, NVMe over fabric, AI and machine learning, to name a few. There are two versions listed for this platform, an SFP56 dual port option offering 25 gigabit per second and a dual port QSFP56 version offering 200 gigabit per second data transfer speeds per port. In this case, the system was outfitted with the Mellanox ConnectX-6 HDR InfiniBand network card with 200 gigabit Ethernet, dual quad small form factor pluggable 56 transceiver slots. This card was developed for a PCI 4.0x16 interface, so with backward compatibility, we're good to go with our PCI 5.0x16 slot. If I ever do go to Italy, I think I'll have to use AMD's established CPU codename destinations. You know, Naples, Rome, Milan, Genoa, Bergamo, and Turin. Although that trip might take a little bit longer than the negative 76 hours I have left for PTO. In the meantime, I do hope you enjoyed this overview of the Gigabyte G493-ZB1 GPU server, featuring 9005 series, or in our case, 9004 series AMD EPYC CPUs, and support for up to 10 Gen 5 GPUs. If you have any comments on this system or any other, post them in the comments section below. If you need more information on this platform, or would like to configure a system, then click one of those links in the description below, or use that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stewart with IT Creations, and thanks for watching. Ciao.